MADIN 2000 is a leading router dynamic software developed by Delta.js. In this video, we show its use for the torsional analysis of a compressor train with motor and gear. After creating a new system and giving it a title, the torsional degree of freedom is selected. Prepared shafts are loaded into the system. In the video about the lateral analysis, you can learn more about creating a shaft model. Afterwards, the two flexible couplings are added to the system. When all components are ready, the shafts and the couplings can be connected. For the connection of gear wheel and pinion, gear properties have to be specified. The gear ratio is determined by the mesh radii and the position of the pinion by an angular value in the MADIN 2000 coordinate system. The mesh stiffness can also be entered. Usually, it affects only the higher modes. In a double helical gear, the gear shafts can be connected at two points. Once the shaft train model has been assembled, it can be visualized with a 3D plot. The first analysis to be carried out is an eigenvalue analysis. In a purely torsional system, the eigenvalues are independent of the rotor speed. The calculated mode shapes can be plotted. According to the Campbell diagram, there is a resonance of the second mode with twice low speed. The flexible coupling variation offers a practical way of finding a suitable coupling stiffness for resonance-free operation. In this example, the impact of the high-speed coupling on the natural frequencies is analyzed. With the resulting frequency versus stiffness diagram, it is easy to determine the appropriate coupling stiffness. After recalculating the eigenvalues with a stiffer high-speed coupling, the Campbell diagram proves that all modes have now more than 10% separation margin from potential excitations at operating speed. Next, a short circuit analysis is carried out. This time-dependent load requires a transient analysis. Transient loads consist of combinations of forces and time functions. In addition to the static load, which has already been entered, we create now the two-phase short circuit load. In the function GUI, a suitable function is selected and the parameters are entered. Then the time-dependent function can be plotted. When the required functions are ready, they have to be combined with the torques. The exciting air gap torque of the two-phase short circuit is applied at the motor, and the static counter torque at the compressor. The completed short circuit load case can be plotted. The analysis for the preload of the compressor train due to nominal operating torque has been carried out beforehand, and we can directly proceed with the two-phase short circuit. The short circuit analysis is carried out as a continuation of the static preload. The linear transient analyses are very fast. Usually, the flexible couplings and the shaft ends are the critical parts of the shaft train. Therefore, we select the two couplings for time history plots of the short circuit response torques. The torque can be plotted in Newton meter or as a multiple of the nominal torque. Many additional features facilitate realistic simulations with complex torsional models. Are you interested in our easy-to-use rotor dynamics software? Feel free to contact us for more information.